In this part, we will continue working on ArcGIS tools, where to extract the length of each sub-basin, we go to the third menu entitled Watershed Processing, and in it we click on Basin Length. And before performing this step, and for the purpose of obtaining correct results, we go to the R toolbox window, and in it we go to Spatial Analyze Tools, then to Hydrology, then we choose Flow Direction, then in Input Surface Raster, we choose Fill Dash Dim 1 layer, then we go to Output Flow Direction Raster, and we specify the location of saving in the project file, where we make a new folder titled Flow Direction, we open this file and we type the save name, then we click on save, then we press OK. Then a message appears indicating that the flow direction process successfully completed. A new layer titled Flow DIR Dash Fill 1 appears as we see. Then we go to the Arc Toolbox window, and in it we go to Spatial Analyze Tools, then to Hydrology, then we choose Basin, then in Input Flow Direction Raster we choose Flow DIR Dash Fill 1 layer, Flow DIR Dash Fill 1 layer, then we go to Output Raster, and we specify the location for saving in the project file, where we make a new folder titled Basin, we open this file, and we type the save name, then we click on save, Then we press OK. A new layer entitled basin-flow-di1 appears. As we see, now we return to the third menu titled Watershed Processing, in which we click on basin length, and in it we go to basin length grid and we choose basin-flow-di1 and we keep the rest of options as they are. Then we press OK. We wait for implementation. Then a message appears indicating that the implementation has not been completed. A new layer titled basin length appears where we may right click on it and then open attribute table. A table appears with the values of basin length for 57 sub-basins only from 107 sub-basins, as we see. To determine the basin length for the rest of sub-basins, the measure tool has been used to extract the basin length for the rest of the sub-basins based on the point of the upstream and downstream through the center of the basin. Where we click on measure tool, then we choose measure line and we choose the distance in kilometers. Then we go to this sub-basin and in it we make a left click on the upstream point, then we make left click on the center point, centroid point, then we make double click on the downstream point. The length of basin appears in the measure window, which is 61 kilometers. In the same way, we find the basin length for the another sub-basin, where we click on the measure tool. We click on measure tool. Then we choose measure line and we choose the distance in kilometers. Then we go to this sub-basin, and in it we make left click on the upstream point. Then we make left click on the centroid point. Then we make double click on the downstream point. The length of basin appears in the measure window, and it is 39.296 kilometers. Thus, in the same way, we find the basin length for the rest of sub-basins. Thus, we calculated the basin length for the sub-basins by going to the third menu and then choosing basin length, or by the measure tool. Thus, we have completed the necessary calculations for quantitative variables for sub-basins in the study area basin. Now we save the project by clicking on Save.